Hello and welcome back to another video on DBT. Oftentimes when we're creating our models, we're working on those YAML files where we're adding descriptions and some more context, but what's the point of that? It's really only a limited amount of value unless that's visible to other people. And especially when you get the question from maybe your stakeholders asking, what does this column mean? What's the logic behind it? The DBT answer for that is providing DBT docs. And this allows you to turn your YAML files that are describing your models into an actual website that other people can look at and use. Here's the page that has a little more information on the specifics of how it works. There are two subcommands that we'll really be focused on, which is generate and serve. If we go back to our project here, we can see we have a description here in some of these files of, you know, the description of the model itself, individual tables. Let's see what else we got here. This one's got a couple of this column, primary key, description. Let's adjust this. This is table one. This is the first table. This is the second table. Doesn't matter. I just want to show that it's different. And if we do DBT docs generate, what will happen here is it will go through your entire project, find all of the YAML files and compile it together into a way that can then be served up as a website. And you can see here, it's actually into a specific JSON file. Now all this information is in here if you really wanted to get into the weeds of it. So now that it's compiled it successfully, let's do the other subcommand, dbt docs serve. And now this is opened up locally on my machine. We can see our sources. It recognizes that these are sources. If you remember in here, this is a source. See if I can get these side by side. Description, details about the sales in the store. That's the name of this table. We can look at the whole source itself, a sample database provided by Snowflake. Let's go to the demo into our project. We can look at the macros, you know, logic in terms of specific macros, breaking it down by your directory. It's matching exactly what we have here. This is the first table, and you can see the actual source code as well, the compiled SQL. So this is really, really useful for end users who might be more comfortable with SQL or just want to know descriptions and information. You can see the tests that are on it. Everything that you're building in your project is now visible to everybody else. And that will save a ton of time in terms of back and forth on questions, because you're putting in that work up front to define it and to document all of these things so that other people can just look at it this way. You can have this based on the project or based on the database. You can look at the actual DAG of how things are getting places. So obviously this second one, this first model influences the second model, and as your DAG really grows, you can see how everything comes into play, the whole lineage of it. And if you want, you can keep this locally on your machine, or another common scenario is people will host this on some sort of web server so that other people can get to it. That's all I wanted to show for this video. I think this is a really cool part of this tool, and I hope you found it helpful. Thanks for watching.